हेलो
यस मैम।
सो व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सिम्पैथोमिमेटिक अमाइंस विल क्विकली गो थ्रू दिस पॉइंट्स सो दैट वी विल बी एबल टू लर्न मोर अबाउट द अदर कैटेकोलामाइंस सो बाय डेफिनेशन सिम्पैथोमिमेटिक और द एड्रेनर्जिक ड्रग्स दीज आर द ड्रग्स विच माइमिक द रिस्पॉन्स प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय स्टिबुलेशन ऑफ सिम्पथैटिक or the adrenergic nerves. Okay, so sympathetic nervous system, it is a part of parasympathetic nervous system. जैसे कि हमने पहले learn किया है parasympathomimetic drugs हमने study किया है. So in that we have discussed कि autonomic nervous system is divided into two types, parasympathetic and sympathetic nervous system. तो sympathetic nervous system का जो neurotransmitter है, उसका नाम क्या है? What is the name of neurotransmitter which is released at the end of sympathetic nerves? It is adrenaline, correct? Okay. So majority of these drugs, they contain intact or partially substituted amino group, and hence they are called as sympathomimetic amines. Okay. By coincidence, what we have discussed in PC2 practical today, amines, right? So the classification says sympathomimetic drugs are divided into two categories: catecholamines. They have catechol nucleus like noradrenaline, adrenaline, isoprenaline, and dopamine. So these substances, these are the neurotransmitters which are released into the bloodstream, and they are present in the body in the normal form naturally. And the non-catecholamines means these are the drugs which do not have the catechol nucleus. So what are the examples of non-catecholamines? Ephedrine and amphetamines. Okay, so let us see. So what are the receptors? So catecholamines, they have the catechol nucleus, and hence the name is catecholamines. What are the different catecholamines, and what are the different types of receptors? Alpha receptors, alpha and beta receptors. So sirf alpha receptor pe effect karega wo kya hai? Noradrenaline. Aur adrenaline jo hai wo dono alpha aur beta dono receptors pe act karta hai, and isoprenaline is one which is acting on beta receptors. Okay. So yesterday we were talking about the effects of adrenergic receptors. Let us quickly go through this, because aaj jo hum isoprenaline or adrenaline ki baat karenge, unka bhi effect is again similar to this, that of produced by adrenaline. So can somebody read this table again? Effect of adrenergic receptors, who will read?
Ma'am.
Yeah, please read. Alpha receptors.
Okay. Alpha receptors, organ, peripheral blood vessels, peripheral blood vessels effect vasoconstriction.
Correct.
Eyes, effect mydriasis.
Correct.
Uterine smooth muscles effect constriction. Intestinal smooth muscle effect contraction.
Correct. Beta receptors.
Beta receptors, heart, increased contractility, bronchi. Heart, increased contractility, increased heart rate, bronchi, bronchodilation, skeletal blood vessels, vasodilation, uterine smooth muscle relaxation, intestinal smooth muscle relaxation, liver glycogenolysis.
Okay. So when I, if I ask you, अगर peripheral blood vessels के ऊपर effect vasoconstriction है, तो इसका action क्या होगा? मतलब ये हम कहाँ पर use कर सकते हैं? ये प्रॉपर्टी हम कौन से कंडीशंस के लिए यूज करेंगे? यस, आई टोल्ड यू. और यहाँ पर जो है बीटा रिसेप्टर का इफेक्ट है, हार्ट इंक्रीजेस कॉन्ट्रैक्टिलिटी, इंक्रीजेस हार्ट रेट. तो ये हम कहाँ पर यूज करेंगे प्रॉपर्टी?
अस्थमा.
नॉट अस्थमा. अगर ब्रोंकाई के ऊपर ब्रोंको डायलेशन है, तो हम इसका यूज करेंगे अस्थमा के लिए, राइट? सो दैट प्रॉपर्टी इज ब्रोंकाई के ऊपर ब्रोंको डायलेशन इफेक्ट है, मतलब अस्थमा के लिए यूज करेंगे. ओके, अगर मैंने कहा हार्ट रेट बढ़ रहा है, इंक्रीज कॉन्ट्रैक्टिलिटी है, या फिर पेरिफेरल ब्लड वेसल्स के ऊपर इफेक्ट क्या है? वाजो कंस्ट्रिक्शन. मतलब क्या होता है? वाजो कंस्ट्रिक्शन होगा तो क्या है, क्या हो जाएगा? ब्लड प्रेशर बढ़ेगा,
ब्लड प्रेशर इंक्रीज होगा.
करेक्ट. तो इसके लिए हमको जब भी समथिंग लाइक वी हैव एनाफाइलेक्टिक शॉक, तो उस कंडीशन में क्या है, वो पर्सन को हाइपोटेंशन है, समथिंग लाइक हिस्टामिन रिलीज हो रहा है तो एलर्जिक रिएक्शंस है. ओके, सो इन दैट केस उसका इफेक्ट रिवर्स करने के लिए ओके, जब भी हमको उस मतलब हाइपोटेंसिव अगर पेशेंट है तो हमको क्या देना है, एड्रेनालिन. क्लियर? तो ये इफेक्ट क्यों आ रहा है, बिकॉज एड्रेनालिन इज एक्टिंग ऑन अल्फा रिसेप्टर्स एंड पेरिफेरल ब्लड वेसल के ऊपर इसका इफेक्ट है वाजो कंस्ट्रिक्शन. अगर आपका ब्लड वेसल कंस्ट्रिक्ट हो गया तो क्या हो जाएगा, ब्लड प्रेशर बढ़ेगा. ओके, हार्ट के ऊपर आप देख सकते हैं बीटा रिसेप्टर्स. सो व्हाट इट इज डूइंग, इंक्रीज हार्ट रेट, इंक्रीज कॉन्ट्रैक्टिलिटी. इफ अ पर्सन इज इन से एनाफाइलेक्टिक शॉक, सो यू नीड टू इंक्रीज द ब्लड प्रेशर राइट इन दैट कंडीशन. इसके लिए हम इसको यूज करेंगे टू इंक्रीज द ब्लड प्रेशर. ओके, फिर आईज के ऊपर हमने देखा इफेक्ट इज मिड्रियासिस. ये इफेक्ट किसके ऑपोजिट है, to that of opposite to that of what we have studied in acetylcholine. Acetylcholine mein jo effect tha meiosis. Okay, there it was decrease in the constriction of the pupil. Okay, so that opposite effect is mydriasis. Then aapko ye samajh mein aa gaya, bronchodilation hai to aap isko asthma mein use kar sakte hain. Uterine smooth muscle constriction. Okay, and then liver. What is the effect of, what is meaning of glycogenolysis? I explained yesterday. Glycogenolysis means क्या है?
Insulin level decrease in insulin level.
Not insulin. You have see metabolism of glycogen. Glycogen is broken down. So what is that effect called? It is called as hypoglycemic effect. Okay. What is that effect called? It is called glycogenolysis means breakdown of glycogen. So effect हो जाएगा hypoglycemia. Okay. Then, बाकी हमने ये देखा skeletal blood vessels effect है vasodilation. Okay, so now we will again quickly summarize the effects of adrenaline. So, can somebody read? Ravi Rathod, Rishikesh, आप पढ़ लेंगे? Rishikesh,
कौन सा मैम?
ये mechanism of action.
Okay. Catecholamines produce their actions by containing receptor. With the receptors membrane. There are two types of receptors for catecholamines, namely alpha and beta receptors. General combination of drugs with alpha receptors increases the tissue activity, while that with the beta receptors inhibits or decreases the tissue activity.
Adrenaline, effect of heart.
Adrenaline, yes. Cardiovascular system, heart. Adrenaline with its action on beta receptors of heart increases heart rate, force of contraction and cardiac output. Extremely high cardiac rate will prevent diastolic filling and may cause fall in cardiac output. It may produce ventricular arrhythmia, myocardial effects of adrenaline and noradrenaline may be blocked by beta receptor blocking agents like propranolol.
Okay, so what is the effect on heart? Adrenaline exacting on the beta receptors, so it will. So always remember this first line. That is, it increases heart rate, increases force of contraction, and increases cardiac output. And what is the antagonistic action drug? Propranolol. Okay. So ये जो effect है, हमने agonist antagonist वाला topic में पढ़ा था कि effect of adrenaline or noradrenaline can be blocked by the beta blocker like propranolol. So sympatholytics mein hum wapas wo dekhenge detail mein kya hota hai uska effect. Then what is the effect on blood vessels? Blood vessels mein pehle kya hota hai, blood vessels of skin and mucous membrane are constricted. Okay, and skeletal muscles ke jo blood vessels hai wo dilate hote hain. So what did I tell you, it is a biphasic response. So what is biphasic response? Initially जब भी अगर हमने एड्रेनालिन दिया तो क्या होता है, एनिमल्स में जो देखा गया है इफेक्ट वो है राइज इन द ब्लड प्रेशर. सो पहले राइज इन द ब्लड प्रेशर एंड देन व्हाट विल हैपन बिकॉज ऑफ कार्डियक स्टिमुलेशन एंड पेरिफेरल वाजो कंस्ट्रिक्शन. तो ऊपर हमने जो देखा कि पेरिफेरल वाजो कंस्ट्रिक्शन मतलब पेरिफेरल जो ब्लड वेसल्स है उसको कंस्ट्रिक्शन करता है एड्रेनालिन एंड कार्डियक स्टिमुलेशन कर रहा है. तो पहले आपको इफेक्ट दिखेगा राइज इन द ब्लड प्रेशर, और ये इफेक्ट जब भी वॉर्न ऑफ होगा तभी क्या हो जाएगा, blood pressure will fall. So what you will write, if you have to write the effect on blood vessels, there is a biphasic response. What is biphasic response? Pehle there will be rise in the blood pressure aur uske baad there will be fall in the blood pressure. Okay, then effect on smooth muscles. I want somebody else to read this. Bronchial smooth muscle and smooth muscles of GIT. Yes, who will read?
Ma'am.
पढ़िए आप.
Smooth muscles, bronchial smooth muscles, adrenal.
एक मिनट रुको. दीपेश will read, please. Let us okay, give ma'am. Everybody chance. Okay.
Bronchial smooth muscle. Adrenaline is a powerful bronchodilator. Due to action on B receptors of bronchi.
Beta receptors
of bronchi. Particularly when the bronchi are constricted as in asthma, smooth muscles of gastrointestinal tract, the muscles of gastrointestinal tract relaxes and the peristaltic movement becomes sluggish. The sphincters are constricted. Okay. Central nervous. Okay.
Yeah, wait. तो ब्रोंकियल स्मूथ मसल पे इफेक्ट क्या है? ब्रोंकोडायलेटर. इसके लिए हम ये प्रॉपर्टी कहाँ यूज करेंगे? अस्थमा. तो अस्थमा का अगर प्रॉब्लम है तो वी आर यूजिंग दिस ड्रग. ओके, बिकॉज इट इज अ ब्रोंकोडायलेटर. और स्मूथ मसल्स के ऊपर जो इफेक्ट है वो है रिलैक्सेशन, लेकिन स्फिंक्टर्स जो है वो कॉन्स्ट्रिक्ट हो जाएंगे. ओके, व्हाट इज द इफेक्ट ऑन सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम? या रीड प्लीज. सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम
Therapeutic doses of adrenaline may give rise to tremors, restlessness, palpitation and apprehension.
Okay, so ye sare iske side effects hai. So we'll mention into adverse effect. Okay, what is the effect on metabolism? Somebody else will read. Aur koi padhega? Effect on metabolism is also important effect.
Ma'am, can I?
Yeah, please.
Metabolism. Adrenaline has significant action on carbohydrate and fat metabolism. It produces hypoglycemia by accelerating glycogen lysis in the liver. Glycogen is breakdown in the skeletal muscles, but there it undergoes anaerobic glycolysis and gives rise to acid lactate, so that blood lactate is increased.
Okay, so I mentioned glycogenolysis. Matlab kya ho raha hai? Glycogen ka breakdown ho raha hai in the skeletal muscles. Okay, and that is why hypoglycemia. Okay, matlab aapka glucose level kam ho raha hai. Okay, but one more thing is there, lactic acid jo hai wo anaerobic glycolysis hota hai, iske liye lactic acid ka level padega. Please read these two. Anti-allergic
action. Adrenaline is a physiological antagonist of histamine and counters the bronchoconstriction and hypotension of anaphylactic shock.
Okay, तो last year आपने जो पढ़े थे diseases, उसमें anaphylactic shock एक था, जहाँ पर आपका bronco constriction हो रहा है, hypotension है, तो ये counteract करने के लिए हम adrenaline use करेंगे. Okay, so what are the therapeutic uses? Somebody please summarize this quickly. Then we'll go to noradrenaline. Yes, what are the therapeutic uses? First use क्या है? In acute bronchial asthma. What is it given by a subcutaneous injection? Secondly, it can be life-saving in acute anaphylaxis. The dose is 0.5 to 1 ml. Third, through the solution of local anesthetic. Okay, why? Because it is causing peripheral blood vessels ka vasoconstriction ho raha hai. Iske liye it is given along with local anesthetic. Then to control hemorrhage, it is applied locally to control capillary bleeding. And in cardiac injection of adrenaline may restore heartbeats, because heartbeat badhta hai, heart rate badhta hai, and that is why this is used in asphyxia and as a nasal decongestant. So all these points everybody will mention if you are asked to write the therapeutic uses. First one is asthma, then in acute anaphylaxis along with local anesthetic to control hemorrhage and to restore the heartbeats. Okay, to ye sab humne स्टार्टिंग में जो इफेक्ट देखे हैं, सो उसका डायरेक्ट रिलेशन है वेयर दे आर यूज्ड. क्लियर है अब तक ये सब? नाउ वी विल गो टू द नेक्स्ट कैटेकोलामाइन, दैट इज नॉरएड्रेनालिन. सो जैसे मैंने कल बताया आपको, एड्रेनालिन और नॉरएड्रेनालिन स्ट्रक्चरल डिफरेंस है कि इसमें एक मिथाइल ग्रुप कम है. सो वी विल डिस्कस इन PC2, दैट टाइम वी विल कम टू नो. सो देयर इज जस्ट वन मिथाइल ग्रुप व्हिच इज लेस हियर, अदरवाइज द स्ट्रक्चर इज सिमिलर टू एड्रेनालिन. Now this is acting predominantly in the alpha receptors, and this increases again the peripheral resistance. Okay, peripheral resistance will increase, and it will increase both systolic and diastolic blood pressure. So what is the use? Again, similarly, we are using this for acute hypotensive shock, right? This is noradrenaline. And so everybody is clear with this? Almost this effects are similar to adrenaline, but what is little action is on D receptors, okay? And it increases peripheral resistance. So it will be again useful for similarly in the acute hypotensive shock condition. Then we have isoprenaline. Isoprenaline is also called as isoprotenol. Just like I have told you agonist, antagonist, make example. So agonist is, if you remember, agonist is isoprotenol and antagonist was propranolol. Okay, so this is acting only on beta receptors. मतलब जो सिर्फ beta receptors के जो effect है, वो ही इसके आपको clearly mention होंगे. So that means it will produce increase in the heart rate, then relaxation of the bronchial smooth muscles, and if you compare the potency, it is 10 times more active than adrenaline, right? So it stimulates heart, causes increase in the cardiac output, and causes increase in the heart rate. Okay, this is mainly used. You can see this. Mainly, it is used as a bronchodilator. And if you have heart block, then it will be used as a cardiac stimulant. This is clear now. Everybody is clear with this concept because it is acting on the beta receptors. So what it is doing? It is increasing the heart rate. Hence, it is used as a cardiac stimulant. If the person is having heart block. Okay, तो पर्सन को हार्ट ब्लॉक है तो उसको हमको कुछ स्टिमुलेशन देना है कार्डियक स्टिमुलेशन दैट इज वेयर द आइसोप्रेनालिन इज इफेक्टिव एंड बिकॉज़ ब्रोंकोडायलेटर इफेक्ट है इसके लिए हम उसको यूज करेंगे इन द अस्थमा ओके आप डोज देख सकते हैं 5 टू 20 मिलीग्राम टैबलेट सबलिंगुअली कैन बी गिवन एंड 10 टू 25% इन द पाउडर फॉर्म इन इनहेलेशन फॉर्म भी दे सकते हैं एंड 10 ml ऑफ 2 मिलीग्राम पर ml एज इन द इनहेलेशन ऑफ द स्प्रे So up to this, everything is clear. We'll go to the next drug that is non-catecholamines. I want somebody else to read the effects of non-catecholamines. Who will read? Yes, Nupur or Nurali, can you read, please, the effect of non-catecholamines.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Non-catecholamine are drugs
without
nucleotide, ephedrine, amphetamine, and other vasopressor agent. These amines act in two ways. First, as a partial agonist or non-adrenaline, and are capable of directly
stimulating. Okay, आपका आवाज ब्रेक हो रहा है.
Receptors yeah. release
noradrenaline.
They release noradrenaline and or dopamine from sympathetic nerve endings. Norcatecholamine differs from catecholamine in the following respects. A. They are effective on oral administration. B. They exhibit resistance to degradation by MAO and hence have longer duration of action. C. In addition of sympathomimetic action, they have powerful CNS stimulant
okay, action. Okay, so I'll explain the few terms. What is vasopressor agent? अब तक हम जो देख रहे थे वो effect of adrenaline on the heart means it is increasing the blood pressure. So what is a vasopressor agent? Anything which will increase the blood pressure is a vasopressor. Okay. तो ephedrine, amphetamine ये भी इसी category के drugs हैं. Sympathomimetic amines. सिर्फ difference क्या है? Without catechol nucleus. Okay. So that is why we are calling it as non-catecholamines. और इसका mechanism of action है one it is partial agonist of noradrenaline. Okay, तो directly alpha और beta दोनों receptors के पर effect करता है और ये directly stimulate करेगा. And secondly, it will release noradrenaline from the sympathetic nerve endings and or dopamine. मतलब dopamine भी release कर सकता है and their effect will be similar. to that of adrenaline, right? So here do teen cheezes jo alag hai from catecholamines. First of all, they are effective on oral administration. So aap oral administration se ye drugs de sakte hain. And secondly, they are resistant to degradation by MAO. What is MAO? MAO is a monoamine oxidase. This is an enzyme which breaks down the catecholamines. So jo aapke noradrenaline, adrenaline, dopamine, ye sab jo neurotransmitters hai, they are degraded by MAO. Lekin non-catecholamines, these are resistant. मतलब ये इसे break down नहीं होंगे, hence इनका जो duration of action है वो आपको ज़्यादा समय तक दिखेगा, fine. Then in addition to the sympathomimetic amines, जो भी हम सारे actions देखे हैं, उसके apart from this, they will also have powerful CNS stimulant. तो मैंने आपको initially mention किया था कि amphetamines ये जो है CNS stimulant की category में आता है, उस इसमें भी हम देखेंगे CNS stimulant कैटेगरी में हम amphetamines ये ड्रग देखेंगे बिकॉज दे हैव अ पावरफुल स्टिमुलेंट एक्शन. सो ये डिफरेंसेस है विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द कैटेकोलामाइंस. ओके, देन वी विल टॉक अबाउट एफिड्रिन. एफिड्रिन इज एन अल्कलॉइड ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम एफिड्रा प्लांट. सो व्हाट आर द फार्माकोलॉजिकल एक्शंस? फर्स्ट, कार्डियोवैस्कुलर सिस्टम, अगेन सेम थिंग, इट इंक्रीजेस फोर्स ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्शन. ओके, इसकी वजह से क्या हो जाएगा? इट विल इंक्रीज द ब्लड प्रेशर, सेम इफेक्ट. ओके, सो इट इंक्रीजेस फोर्स ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्शन एंड इट इंक्रीजेस कार्डियक आउटपुट. सो इट ऑल्सो कॉजेस पेरिफेरल वैसो कंस्ट्रिक्शन. और इस सब का टुगेदर इफेक्ट क्या हो जाएगा? ब्लड प्रेशर बढ़ेगा. ओके, सो व्हाट इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ एफिड्रिन ऑन कार्डियोवैस्कुलर सिस्टम? इट इज सेम वे, दैट इज द ब्लड प्रेशर इज इंक्रीजिंग, फाइन. देन repeated administration of ephedrine fails to produce same response because of tachyphylaxis, and as compared to adrenaline, its vasopressor effects persist for longer time. मतलब duration of action है ये, ज़्यादा समय तक आपको ये मिलेगा. So that is with respect to अगर हम adrenaline compare करते हैं तो, fine. Then smooth muscles, again same effect. Smooth muscle, bronchial smooth muscles relaxant effect है, okay. And the relaxation is less prominent, but it persists for long. मतलब duration of action आपको इसमें ज़्यादा मिलेगा. It also relaxes uterine smooth muscles. Central nervous system, similar kind of effects: restlessness, tremors, insomnia, and increases mental activity. अगर mental activity increase हो रहा है, तो हम इसको कहाँ पर use कर सकते हैं ये property? Where we can use this property? Okay, I'll tell you that concept. Then we have eyes ke upar bhi same effect hai, that is mydriasis, and metabolic effect is increases metabolic rate of oxygen consumption, fine. So what are the therapeutic uses of ephedrine? Pehla point same hai, bronchial asthma. Then we have nasal congestion, hypotension, because ye blood pressure ko bada raha hai, iske liye hum hypotension mein use karenge. Okay, so I was coming talking about this point ki central nervous system pe ye kya produce kar raha hai? Increases mental activity. ये effect को हम कहाँ पर use करेंगे? Narcolepsy. Narcolepsy is a condition where the person is feeling sleepy. Okay, narcolepsy is a condition where the person is feeling sleepy. तो amphetamine और ephedrine का ये effect है, increase mental activity. So this effect we are using. And then yesterday we discussed what is myasthenia gravis, that is a muscular weakness. There we are using again and in heart block. So what are the uses of ephedrine? First, in bronchial asthma, nasal decongestant, hypotension. मतलब blood pressure अगर किसी का कम है patient का, if he is having hypotensive condition, तो उसका blood pressure बढ़ाने के लिए हम use करेंगे. Narcolepsy means if the person is feeling sleepy. Okay, what is the effect? The effect is increased mental activity. इसके लिए हम narcolepsy में भी use कर सकते हैं, and then in heart block. Okay. So the adverse effects are similar, that is palpitation, tremor, severe hypertension, arrhythmia, and acute pulmonary edema. So anybody has any doubt so far? You can ask. Waiting to be treated.